We are gathered here today to remember the heroic actions committed by the first responders and civilians that lost their lives on this day 15 years ago.
To reflect upon how that day changed our lives, as well as our world. To reflect upon what we will say to our children and our grandchildren. And to respond to that. To respond to the clarity of that attack, which reminds us how uncertain and precious life is, and how each day we must seize the opportunity to be the best people we can be, to contribute, to have purpose, to have honor, to defend and protect our families and our democracy. So on this day, we will remember what happened, the event that changed our world, that changed our lives, the event that remembers the unconditional bravery of first responders, the event that caused our nation to enter Afghanistan that same year.
And they failed to deter our spirit, our fighting spirit, as witnessed by the service of not only our student veterans on our campus today, but those Blue Raiders whose names are engraved on this memorial for giving the ultimate measure of sacrifice to our nation. Abraham Lincoln, recalling the toil of the Civil War, said at Gettysburg that it was, and I quote, altogether fitting and proper, end of quote, to gather and remember those who gave their lives for this country.
Close to 3,000 people lost their lives in the World Trade Center on September 11, 2001. Along with the office workers trapped inside the buildings, police officers and firefighters were a large number in the death toll. To date, this was the deadliest day in history for the New York City firefighters, where 343 of their men and women were killed, helping evacuate people from the towers. Sorry, y'all.